stars are falling down in your sweet hair. The stars in the sky look down where you lay. My little Lord Jesus has slipped on the hay.
snowflakes falling from the sky on the walls and housetops. Snowflakes stick, they lie on the window ledges, on the branches bare. Now how fast they gather, gathering all the air. Look into the garden where the grass was green, covered by the snowflakes, not a blade is seen. Now the branches are soft and white. Every twig is laid, what pretty sight.
How do snowmen get around? They ride icicles. What do snowmen have for breakfast?
Snowflakes!
What goes oh, oh, oh? Santa walking backwards.
How does Darth Vader enjoy his Christmas turkey? The dark side.
What do snowmen wear on their head?
Snow caps!
What do monkeys sing at Christmas time?
Jingle bells.
What type of motorbike does Santa ride?
A Harley Davidson.
What did Adam say before Christmas?
It's Christmas Eve! Why don't penguins fly? They're not big enough to be pilots.
What did the stamp say to the Christmas card?
Stick with me.
Stick with me.
And we'll go places.
Why
does the snowman looking in carrots? To pick in his nose.
Pick your nose.
Chapter 2, Ruth 11.
so happy that I can see you again. Wonderful time with my family and friends. Ain't nothing better than this, yeah. For all we know, this time may not come around again. And that's why I never want it to end. It's such a beautiful bliss. Oh, happy feelings everywhere. We're dancing in the Christmas cheer. The kids are waiting in their beds for Santa. Oh, Santa, I don't have a long list this year. The presents is my present here. Christmas spirit in the air is all I need.
One day, God sent an angel named Gabriel to a town called Nazareth. The angel went to visit a young virgin named Mary. She was engaged to be married to Joseph, a descendant of King David. The angel said to Mary, "Rejoice! You have found favor with God. He is with you." Mary was very afraid and puzzled. Why would God find favor with her? She had done nothing special. "Do not be afraid," the angel said. Then he told Mary that she was going to have a very special and unique baby, and they would call the baby Jesus, which means the Lord saves. The angel explained that the baby would be great. He would be God's son. He would even be a king. The king God had promised would come. Mary asked the angel, "How can that happen? I am not married yet." The angel replied, "God will be the father of the baby. The baby will be God's son." Then the angel told Mary, "Nothing will be impossible with God." He said that Mary's relative Elizabeth was pregnant, even though she was old and did not have any children. "May everything happen just as you said," Mary replied. Then the angel left her. Mary hurried to her relative Elizabeth's house. When she arrived, the baby inside Elizabeth leaped for joy. The Holy Spirit filled Elizabeth and she said, "What an honor, Mary. Your baby will be blessed too." Mary was so happy. She praised God with a song about how great God is. Mary knew every family in the future would say she was blessed because God was going to do great things for her through Jesus. God was keeping his promise to bless the whole world through Jesus. Mary stayed with Elizabeth for 3 months. Then she went home. Now Joseph found out Mary was going to have a baby, but Joseph knew it was not his baby. Mary and Joseph were not married yet. Joseph decided to quietly break his engagement with Mary so she would not be publicly disgraced. Soon after Joseph thought these things, an angel appeared to him in a dream. "Joseph," the angel said, "don't be afraid to take Mary as your wife, because the baby she is carrying was put there by the Holy Spirit. Mary is going to have a son. Name him Jesus, because he is going to save his people from their sins." This happened just like the prophet said it would. "See, the virgin will become pregnant and give birth to a son, and they will name him Emmanuel," which is translated, "God with us." When Joseph woke up, he did exactly as the angel commanded. He married Mary. And when she had a son, Joseph named him Jesus. The baby Jesus fulfilled Isaiah's prophecy, as well as other Old Testament prophecies about the coming Savior. Through his life, death, and resurrection, Jesus fulfilled God's plan of redemption that God planned before the world began.
Fields as they lay in fields where they
John, one of Jesus' disciples, wrote to tell people about who Jesus is. John wrote that the word Jesus existed in the beginning, before the world even began. The Word has always existed with God, and the Word has always existed as God. He was with God in the beginning. When God spoke at creation, all things were created through His Word. Not one thing was created apart from Him. The Word brought life into the world and light for all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness could not hide it. God sent a man named John the Baptist to be a witness to the light. John was not the light, but he came to tell people about the light so they might believe. The true light was coming into the world to give light to everyone. When Jesus came into the world, people did not recognize him. His own people did not accept him, but this is good news. To everyone who did accept him, he gave them the right to be a part of God's family, to be children of God. The Word became a human and lived among us. People saw his glory, the glory of the one and only Son of God. He was full of grace and truth. John the Baptist told people that even though Jesus came into the world after him, Jesus is greater because he existed before John. People received blessings from Jesus, grace upon grace. Long ago, God gave people the law through Moses. But now, he has given us grace and truth through Jesus Christ. No one has ever seen God, but Jesus, God's one and only Son, has shown us what God is like. The birth of Jesus was good news. Jesus was no ordinary baby. He was God's Son, sent to earth from heaven. Jesus came into the world as a human to bring us life. He brought light into darkness and showed us what God is like.